Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Somehow, amazingly, it is already the end of June, so I am filming for you today my very first monthly favorites video. Now, I'm not making it beauty favorites or fitness favorites or food favorites or lifestyle favorites. I'm just gonna film the top 10 things, the top 10 items that made my life better and easier this month. And I think it'll differ a little bit month to month, but today I've just got 10 items, 10 products that if I did not have those things this month, my life wouldn't have been as awesome as it was in June. I'm gonna start off with three sort of beauty and skincare related items. I'm not a huge makeup person collector, like I'm definitely not a beauty vlogger, but I'm obviously a female and I care about my skin and I care about my appearance. So I'm gonna give you three things that I kind of couldn't live without this month. Item number one is this Sugar Face scrub from Fresh. It is Fresh Sugar Face Polish, and it's a natural exfoliant with real strawberry seeds that refines and nourishes. Okay, so I have been using those little like exfoliating pads, like the little kind of chemical exfoliating pads, and they were working pretty well for a while, and then at some point they just kind of lost their potency for me, and I needed like a really strong physical scrub. And I had used this, I don't know, this product's been around for forever, and I had used this a while back, maybe in my 20s, and I kind of forgot that it existed, but I went into Sephora and I told the sales clerk, I just said, I need like a good exfoliator that like gets stuff off your face. And she steered me in this direction, and I have totally used this before, and it has just been making everything so much smoother and my life so much better this summer. I've been using it about once a week, sometimes twice, when I'm feeling like I'm getting some extra buildup or I've been wearing a lot of makeup, which I don't normally do. This is what it looks like on the inside. It's brown, and if you smell it, it smells kind of citrusy or fruity and sugary. And my only kind of weird complaint about this is if you get it near your mouth, it tastes, it's sugar. It tastes really sweet. So there's this temptation to be like, nom, 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 like maybe I should eat my face mask, which I'm sure it's totally safe to do, but I like, that's not the goal of this product, and it's way too expensive just to be like eating it. So yeah, this is my favorite number one, Fresh Sugar Face Polish, super good exfoliator. This is an oldie but a goodie, and I will be purchasing another one of these as soon as I run out, which will likely be very soon. Okay, the next product that I want to highlight in terms of beauty and skincare is the Too Faced Hangover Prescription Face Primer. And I'm not a big face primer kind of person. Like, I don't love to have moisturizer and another layer of like silicone-y feeling goop on my face and then my BB cream or my foundation or whatever I'm doing. But this stuff kind of gives like an extra layer of hydration and moisture, and then once I put it on, it seems like my foundation or my BB cream or whatever I'm using that day goes on extra smooth. So this is silicone free, and it kind of smells like coconut. It has a really nice kind of summery scent to it. It goes on really light, and it kind of keeps my skin from like getting dried out and dehydrated during the day. One thing I'll tell you about myself, I'm a hot yoga teacher. I spend most of my time in a room that's like 100 degrees, and it's very easy for the moisture to just like get zapped out of my skin. So this has been kind of a lifesaver. I've been using this for a few months now, and let's see if I can get it up close to the camera. This is a really well-known product as well. I'm sure you've seen it before, but it's the Too Faced Prescription Hangover Prescription Moisturizer. The last item that I'm going to share with you in terms of beauty today is this Givenchy kind of lip balm. I think it's called a Rouge Vinyl Lipstick, but it's really more of a lip balm in lipstick form. And the shade is Noir Revelateur. Noir Revelateur. I got a sample of this a while back from Sephora, like a little mini tube, and I opened it up, and you can see it looks like you're gonna get this kind of super dark, kind of gothic lip look. It looks almost black when you take it out of the tube, but when you put it on, it goes on really sheer, and it's one of those lipsticks that kind of claims to adapt to your skin tone and your lip pigmentation. I don't really know like what kind of science there is behind that. All I know is it goes on relatively sheer, and for me, it's just shows up a shade, like two or three shades darker than my natural lip color. It's what I have on today. As far as like it being a lipstick is concerned, I would say it's pretty average, but what I love about this is it's incredibly moisturizing. This is better than almost any lip balm that I think I own, and instead of just putting on something clear and goopy on my lips, I just add this. So I've got a little bit of color, my lips have stayed really hydrated, I've been using this like at night even instead of like kind of more heavy duty moisturizers. This stuff is just great. This is my second tube. I think I'm gonna get through it pretty quickly. And this is probably my favorite lip product of the year so far. So it's the Givenchy, what did I call it? Rouge Vinyl in Noir Revelateur. I'll link it below. I'm not a beauty expert, but this stuff is awesome. I can tell you that much. Okay, moving on from beauty, very important stuff, but definitely not my realm of expertise. Moving on from beauty, I have a book that I will recommend. This book has kind of gotten me through the month, and it was kind of a surprise for me, and it is Mark Manson's The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Frack, okay? Or you can fill in the blank yourself. I'm trying to keep this channel like relatively clean. I kind of curse a lot in real life and I'm trying to knock it off for the YouTube at least. But I wasn't sure what to expect. I saw an interview with Mark Manson on another channel and I thought he seemed like a really intelligent guy. And when I saw the title of his book, I was like, I don't know, do I really want to purchase that? That seems kind of gimmicky. But this book has really kind of gotten me out of my own head about my fear of being judged by other people, and my fear of like screwing up and making mistakes. And it's allowed me to kind of shift my mindset about what is actually important to me and what are the things that I'm doing for me versus what are the things that I'm doing because I'm expected to be doing them. It's been a really great way to kind of examine my priorities and, I don't know, summon up a little bit of courage to be doing the things that I actually want to do. I will be honest and say that without this book, I probably would not have started a YouTube channel this month. That's how much this has impacted me. Now, there are a couple things in this book, like there's a few sentences here and there, or a couple examples that he gives here and there that are directed toward his target audience, which I guess is like dudes that are crass, because there are a couple things in this book that are just crass, and you know, I just can't, I don't know, like I find them to be like mildly offensive or just in poor taste. But if you can get past a few of those gimmicky shock factor sentences, and there's only a few of them, the content of this book is really smart. I'm not that self-helpy, but this has been one of the most helpful books for myself that I have read lately. I'm gonna link this down below. Again, it's Mark Manson's The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fill in the Blank Yourself. Okay, the next thing I'm going to share with you is also a book, but in addition to being a book, it is a lifestyle choice, or it is at least a 30-day lifestyle choice, and that is the book The Whole 30 by Melissa Hartwig and Dallas Hartwig. And this diet has been around for a handful of years now, and it's basically an elimination program. You set aside 30 days of your life, and you cut out dairy, any added sugar, all grains, all alcohol, and all legumes. So that's kind of a lot of stuff. You're basically left with meat, nuts, fruits, and vegetables, and not much else. And I did this. I did this whole program this month. I started actually at the end of May, and I completed it toward the end of June. And I was skeptical. I kind of did it reluctantly and with, I don't know, and with some hesitation, and it took some nudging from a few other people in my life to make me give it a try, but I can honestly say that it has changed my mindset when it comes to food, and I learned a ton about what helps my body run well. I had a rocky time, probably the first 10 or 12 days, but once I got into the second half of the program, I had incredible energy. I stopped taking naps. Like, I was a daily napper before I did the Whole 30. I took no more naps. I didn't have that midday slump that people often get, you know, like 3 or 4 p.m. when you just like need to sit down or you're kind of, your brain just checks out. That went away from me. I started getting up earlier in the morning. My workouts have been better. And yes, I did lose a little bit of weight. I lost about 5 pounds on the program. I didn't have much to lose, and that's not why, why I did it, but I did lose about 5 pounds, which for me is a significant amount of weight in 30 days. So I will enthusiastically recommend this program. It is a commitment. It is 30 days of your life when you're probably not going out to eat. It's not a good idea to plan it around a vacation or around travel or over the holidays. But I don't know, I was a skeptic and now I'm a believer. I'm gonna link to the Whole 30 website down below. And if you have questions about this, post them in the comments. I'm actually gonna do a round 2 of Whole 30 with my husband when we get back from vacation, so kind of mid-July-ish, and I'm considering doing a little bit of vlogging or doing a video series on how Whole 30 goes the second time around for me and the first time around for him. So if you're curious about that, let me know in the comments, because I'm seriously considering devoting some video time to this. Okay, the next thing I'm gonna share with you for my kind of top 10 things of June is related to my Whole 30 journey, and it is a snack. It is a Lara bar. These have been around for quite a while, and this was one of the only bars, like things that you could take on the go, that was Whole 30 approved. And I have a few days of the week when I'm teaching, you know, at opposite ends of town, or I'm running from the gym to a yoga class, to another yoga class, and then to here and to there. And so I've been kind of in the habit of bringing protein bars or energy bars with me for those days when I just need something quickly and I'm kind of running around. Well, almost all of the protein bars that I reach for were totally forbidden on Whole 30, but these were recommended to me, these Lara bars, and they don't have as much protein as like protein bars do, but they have a good amount, and they are all natural. They're made mostly of fruit and nuts and dates. And my favorite flavor was this flavor, the apple pie flavor. And let me tell you, if you've been off of sugar for a while, these start to taste really sweet and really yummy and almost like dessert. So they warn you on Whole 30, like, don't go overboard on the Lara bars. They're for emergencies only. And I was pretty good about not abusing the Lara bars, but I'm a big fan of these, and I'm off of Whole 30 now, but I have a stash still left in my kitchen, and I've been taking these around instead of my typical protein bars, which would have soy and dairy and stuff in them, because I found out I'm a little bit sensitive to those things. So Lara bars for the win. Apple pie flavor especially, good healthy snack, use in moderation. Okay, moving forward, I have a couple of fitness related items that I will list in my top 10 of this month. And the first thing I want to share are my new running shoes. Yay, new running shoes. And if you've been following my channel, you've probably heard me talk about running just a little bit. I'm not a runner by heart, but I've been running more and more as part of just my regular fitness routine. I've been doing a lot of high intensity intervals. I've been kind of pushing my distance a little bit. I have signed up for my first ever 10K next month, and I am planning to run the Wine and Dine Half Marathon in Walt Disney World in November. So I'm upping my running game, which meant that I needed to invest in some pretty good running shoes. Let me tell you, it makes a huge difference to invest in a pair of running shoes that fit your needs. I have had much better workouts. My feet have had so much less like pain and aching and cramping, and I'm running faster. I am running faster in these shoes. And I love that inside the shoe, if you can see it, it says, run faster. Well, I'm running faster thanks to these Nikes. I'll put a link to these down below because they are cute and they are pretty amazing shoes. However, if you are a runner and you're looking to invest in running shoes, don't just buy the ones that I'm recommending. Go to an actual running store, get your feet looked at, get your gait looked at, and then try on a bunch of shoes and find the one that like feels like it fits you like a glove and like, you know, like it was made for you, and it will make all the difference in your running game. I also have another fitness item for you, and this is actually a pair of leggings. It is the Lululemon, of course it's Lululemon. It's the Lululemon Align Pant, Lululemon Align Leggings. And these are, I wear these to teach yoga, and I wear these to work out, and I wear these to go running, and I wear them just around in life. And I have been a Lululemon fan for a long time. I've got a lot of Lulu clothes. I've been in yoga for well over a decade. I've been in the fitness industry for well over a decade. So I have a big stash of yoga clothes and workout clothes. But these pants have changed my life. And I actually have a pair on right now. So I've got these navy ones. And I also have, let me see if I can show you on my, get on my stool here. I also have on these. They're kind of a foresty green, and they have a really, really high, let me see if I can show with my camera. They have a really high waistband, and they hug you in like just enough. So they're not like squishing my tummy. I'm not getting any rolls. I can wear these for a long time, and I don't feel like they are cutting off my circulation. Like if I have a long day, like if I'm teaching 4 yoga classes or I'm in the studio from like 9 a.m. till 6 p.m., I put on my Aligns because they don't start to bug me. I don't feel all gross in them. They wick away moisture, and they're just, they're the best pants. So I think I've gushed about these enough. I gotta get my camera back where I want it here. Ah, there we go. But yeah, the Lulu Aligns, they're not cheap, but they are a great investment. They're my new ride or die yoga, running, workout, hangout, legging. Okay, I have 2 more things for June favorites. They're both kind of random. The next thing I'm going to recommend is actually, it's actually a supplement. It's actually like an herbal supplement. It's called Trifala, and I think it's just like a natural Indian herbal formula, and it helps you be regular. It helps you have regular bowel movements. Now, I know that sounds kind of gross to talk about that on this channel, but you know what? That's what I'm talking about. That's my life right now. I did that whole 30, and I also did an experiment this month with cutting out carbohydrates, and I found that I wasn't getting as much fiber as I sometimes was used to getting, especially when I started taking out starchy vegetables and some fruit. Like, I was getting a little bit less fiber, and I just needed a little bit of help keeping things flowing smoothly. And so a friend of mine who works in nutrition recommended that I try this supplement, and it's pretty inexpensive. I got it off Amazon, and I just take one pill in the evening and one pill in the morning, and everything is flowing very nicely. And it's not like, you know, if you take a whole bunch of fiber pills and then suddenly you have to run to the bathroom with explosive diarrhea. It's nothing like that. It just feels like a good, healthy, clean movement. So I don't know if that's TMI, but this really is in my top 10 must-have items of the month. This is the Trifala. I will link to this one below. You may just want to do a little bit of research. I don't think there's any major like worries or contraindications. It says do not use if pregnant or nursing. Do not use if pregnant or nursing. I'm not pregnant yet or nursing, but this stuff has been really good to have around. My final favorite for June is something that's kind of silly. It's actually a deck of cards. It's a deck of cards that have affirmations printed on them, and they are called affirmators. And you can see on the package that it already just looks ridiculous. There is a rainbow, and there is a unicorn, and then there is a bunny rabbit riding a unicorn. First of all, if you know anything about me, you will know that unicorns and bunny rabbits are my jam. So when I saw the bunny on the unicorn, I knew, okay, like these are definitely meant for me. And basically it's a deck of cards. You open it up, you see a little stack, and then every day you can just take a card off the top, and on the back it has an affirmation for you. It has a little bit of inspiration or some words to live by, and they're always like a little bit cute. They have little individual illustrations for each one. Some of them are kind of silly, some of them are kind of serious. Sorry for the weird lighting, it's just how it is today. And they're all just kind of silly like this, and there's a different one, you know, there's enough to take a different one every day for quite a while. And they're just, I've been looking at these here and there for some extra inspiration and for some laughs, and they are just making me really happy. So if you need some affirmations and you have a good sense of humor, I highly recommend the Affirmators deck, and I will link to this down below. Okay, everybody, that is it for my very first ever monthly favorites video. These items were in no specific order, no real rhyme or reason. I just picked out the top 10 things that I think made my life a lot better during the month of June. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Hit subscribe below. I've got a lot of kind of fun content coming up in the time between this video and the next monthly favorites, which will be at the end of July. And I hope you're having a great summer. I hope June treated you really well. I hope you have a safe 4th of July, and I hope to see you back on this channel really soon. Bye.